Corkle Free Will Baptist Church Christmas Cantata 2016. We're so excited that you've come to share this very special night with us, the night that we sing and celebrate the birth of Christ.
We're all family here, so just go ahead and relax and say hi to the one that's sitting beside you. Just go ahead and do that right now. All right? Now let's just settle in and relax. The miracle began thousands of years ago in the sacred words of the scripture and the solemn songs of the prophets.
The world was waiting in darkness, but God's promise assured his people that his presence would one day live among them.
Lift up your eyes. The Lord's glory appears over you.
Nations will come to light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn.
And so God's appointed time had come. The world had never known or heard of Mary, a devout Nazarene girl, who would be chosen by Jehovah God.
The world took little notice of an obscure village hidden in the Judean evening. That village was Bethlehem.
Oh, but on this holy night, the world would change forever with the birth of a tiny baby. His name, Jesus. Rejoice, rejoice, Christ has come.
Rejoice, our Savior is among us.
And in his coming, he's opened heaven's doors. In his coming, he's shown us the way.
In his coming, he calls us before eternity's throne. Christ is born today. Christ was born to save. Christ was born for this.
Emmanuel, God with us. He left his celestial splendor to be born in the most humble of circumstances. A rough stable, common manger on a dark and silent night. And in the coming to our earthly plane, we have been ushered into his very presence.
And oh, what a holy invitation to marvel with the shepherds, to worship with the kings, to sing with the heavenly host. We are forever transformed by his presence, and we will never be the same.
For this is Christmas. This is the miracle of the incarnate love, to stand in the presence of the Father.
And to bow in the presence of his Son. Christ is born. Emmanuel is with us. And high above the hills of Bethlehem, the sky is filled with the heavenly host.
And the voices of thousands of angels awaken slumbering shepherds, calling them to rejoice. A Savior is born.
Gloria, Gloria.
shepherds who lived near Bethlehem were out at night in their fields just watching over their flocks. They were there just sitting there when suddenly there was a bright light. Now this wasn't just any bright light. This light was so bright that the shepherds had to shield their eyes for a moment. When they opened their eyes to see what was going on, a beautiful angel was standing above them with his arms open wide.
Then the angel spoke to them, "Do not be afraid. I'm here to bring you good news for all people. Today in Bethlehem, a baby has been born. He's the one that will save the world. You'll find the baby because he'll be wrapped in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger." The shepherds were amazed and excited. And did everyone know this or just them? They had to go see this baby the angels were talking about.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory.
wonder if Mary realized the power and the authority and the majesty that she cradled in her arms that first morning, wrapped in swaddling clothes and gaining nourishment from her, was very God. She had just given birth to the one who created her, the fullness of the Godhead looking her around with wide-eyed wonders of a newborn. Every mother counts the fingers and toes of her newborn child
to make
sure they're all right. But I wonder if Mary realized that those tiny hands that curled about her fingers were the same hands that formed mankind. Those little feet that were the same feet that walked on streets of gold and been worshipped by angels. That tiny infant voice that once spoken worlds into existence on the first morning when she kissed the newborn child. She wasn't just kissing a baby. She was kissing the face of God.
That your baby boy will one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hands? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead
alone. Our hope is found. He is our life, he is our strength, and he is our song.
Mm-hmm.
It was no ordinary night, for lying in a lowly manger was the Christ child. Tenderly he lay so meek and mild. The heavens and the earth were filled with praise. It was no ordinary night as all creation stood in wonder at the glory of this child, filled with hope and light and mercy.
Thank you.
And though Jesus is here with us now, not all the world bows to acknowledge him. But believers, take heart, for the day is coming when he will reign in full and rule over all. In a world where words like bullets fly, we turn our faces to the sky. We're watching, we're waiting. There are times it seems despair and strife are such a part of our daily life that we're longing and we're aching. We pray for a Prince of Peace to dry our eyes and to mend our grief. You speak a word and wars will cease where we are praying for a Prince of Peace.
I heard the bells on Christmas Day. They're all familiar carols play. And mild and sweet their songs repeat.
We stand in awe at what Jesus has done for us. We come with worshipful hearts, and knowing that we've done nothing to deserve His coming to us. We're simply sinners in need of a Savior. Grateful that You came and changed the darkness away from our night. We ask that You make Yourself at home in our hearts, Lord, and may our lives become the manger where You were born time and time again in us. For those among us who know sorrow, we ask You to bring them joy. Those who lost their way in darkness at night, let the star of Bethlehem guide them home. Lord, be our Prince of Peace and throw the world of chaos. And protect our children. Give us wisdom in all our decisions. Be Lord of our careers and our relationships. And let Your secure arms enfold those who are walking in winter seasons of life. Give us peace. Give us joy. Give us hope, Lord. Fill our hearts with Your love. And may we share that love with everyone we come in contact with. Not just here and there, but every single day we may live.
At this point this evening, we want to talk to you for just a minute. We've sung, and we've heard, and we've listened to how a child came. He came as a holy child, ordained of God. How a virgin gave birth to this child. The angels sung, the world was at awe at that time. And we realized that He didn't come just to be sung to. He didn't come just to do healings in people's bodies, but that the purpose of Jesus Christ was to die for the remission of men's sins. That our life may be perfect and put together, made whole. One Christmas when I was 10 years old, I've got a younger sister, and as we opened gifts, she opened a box of bullets for a shotgun. She tossed them to me, and I smiled and received them. I said, Mom and Dad must have marked that wrong. We chuckled and we went on. My mom and dad smiled. And a few minutes later, my sister opened her brand new little 410 single shot shotgun. Perfect with rainbow wood grain. And I looked back at her and she needed the gift back that she had handed me. Will you say, preacher, I'm telling you, salvation does not take anything away from you. Accepting Jesus Christ into your life merely is the missing piece of the puzzle that we call life. It's the gift that you need to fulfill this life and the next to come. They're going to sing a song in just a second. And as they're singing, we want to invite you, if you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, we want to invite you to come. Come and pray at either of these altars, and I will meet you right there. Come just as you are. Come weary. Come cold. Come not feeling God in your life in a long time. Come just because someone invited you tonight, and now all of a sudden you've realized, I don't know Jesus as my Savior. Come just as you are tonight as they sing, and I'll meet you right here at this altar. We'll pray together. Explain to you how that none of us were right. We all need the Lord. And the Lord wants you tonight. He's got that gift. And He wants to give it to you. But you'll have to accept it tonight.
wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Long before an angel disrupted the shepherd's night with the announcement of a Savior, God was already preparing the hearts of people living in darkness. Help was on the way. A Redeemer was coming.
Glory, hallelujah, hear the angels sing. Spread the good news of a newborn king. Glory, hallelujah, hear the angels sing. Gloria.
More than Jesus' birth. It anticipated his sinless life, which qualified him to be God's sacrificial lamb. The angels rejoice because the day of salvation is here. Amen.
Sky. They said, boys, don't you be afraid. This is the night of your life. There's a baby in a manger that the whole world needs to know. If you get to it, you, here's what you must do. Go tell your brother too. Tell it to everybody you meet. Tell him you've got good news. Oh, tell him about the little baby born in Bethlehem. Tell him his name is Jesus and he's coming to free us.
Go tell.
Poor and the lame, and if they were able, those cows in the stable would praise his holy name.
Once again evokes images of angels and shepherds and kings bearing gifts. Yet even as our traditions continue to evolve, the one constant that remains is the reason for the season.
Amen.
And that reason is Jesus Christ the Lord.
There's a reason that the lights are shining. There's a reason that the wreaths are hung. There's a reason songs of joy and peace are being sung. Ooh, yeah. There's a reason for the celebration. Oh, yeah. There's a reason that the silver bells ring. There's a reason for the season.
There's a reason that the lights are shining.
There's a reason.
There's a reason that the wreaths are.
Yes, there's a reason.
There's a reason that songs of joy and peace are being sung. Well, there's a reason for the celebration. There's a reason that the silver bells ring. There's a reason for the season,
and the reason is Christ the King. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there's a reason.
There's a reason. Oh, there's a
reason. There's a reason.
There's a reason. Yes, there's a reason.
You know the Savior came down from glory and set us free. Well, He came to bring us hope eternal,
and hope can change everything.
There's a reason for the season. There's a reason for the tinsel and holly, and all the decorations on the tree.
Yes, there's a reason.
There's a reason for the time we spend with our family.
Ooh.
Well, it's a glorious heavenly party.
Ooh.
That goes beyond the reds and the greens.
Oh.
There's a reason for the season, and the reason is. Oh, yes. Well, there's a reason.
There's a reason. Oh, there's
oh,
a reason.
Oh, there's a reason.
There's a reason. Yes, there's a reason.
You know the Savior came down from glory to set us free. I'm glad He came to bring us hope eternal. And hope can change everything. There's a reason for the season, and the reason is Christ the King.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there's a reason.
There's a reason. Oh, there's a reason.
There's a reason.
Yes, there's
it's more than the light.
There's a reason. Oh,
more than the decorations on the tree.
There's a reason. Yes, there's
it's all about hope.
There's a
blessed
reason.
Hope.
Oh,
there's a reason.
Oh,
Jesus,
Jesus,
there's a reason,
Jesus,
and I know
there's a reason,
I know He's the reason,
oh,
there's a reason,
there's a reason, yes, there's a reason,
you know the Savior came down from glory to set us free, and He came to bring us hope. And hope can change everything.
There's a reason for the season, and the reason is Christ the King.
Oh yeah!
There's a reason for the season, and the reason is Christ the King.
There's a reason for the season.
We're so thankful to have each and every one of you tonight. Let's give another hand.